What's up, challengers? Welcome to the gym. My name is Gym Leader Gio, and this is week 9 of the 5th season of the GBA in the Giantes matchup against the Pittsburgh Pirates and their coach, Old Man Tup. We have battled Old Man Tup once before, both in this league format and in this season, because we are in the same conference. So this is our big rematch. We're looking to recreate that big 5-0 win that we had last time. I'm going to hit battle start. If you're curious about the team I brought, check out the locker room, the video that went up just previous to this video. So we're going to get into it now. I predict, here we go. Okay, this is almost exactly what I predicted. I have written down here, Excadrill, Celebi, Arcanine, Jellicent, Thundurus, and Kyurem. And is that exactly what he brought? Excadrill, Arcanine, Jellicent, Celebi, Kyurem, and yes, and Thundurus. So I feel very well equipped for this team. Very well equipped. We're going to have to see if he's got some unique changes to some of these Pokemon. We've been seeing him running an offensive Arcanine a little more as of late. But I'm still not too worried about that. Looking at this, his only real rock setters are the Excadrill and the Celebi. So I think I'm going to lead with Remix here. Because good leads for him. The Thundurus is a good lead for him, a potential momentum grabber. Either of his rockers are a good lead for him. I'd like to get as much information on as many sets as possible as early as possible, so I'm going to lead with Remix here and sort of play it by ear thereafter. So, here we go. Hitting confirm. Hitting confirm. He's taking a little while here. He's probably going to try and predict my lead. Hippowdon is the person I led with last time against him, and also what I would consider to be an obvious lead, get Stealth Rocks off early, but I think I'm gonna have plenty of opportunities to do that later on in the match. So, let's get into it! Giantes Pittsburgh Pirates. We're getting into this rematch right now. Whew, I'm nerve-sided. Nerve-sided, guys. Nervous and excited. Remix comes out. Who are we mimicking? Is it Uzi Gunner? Rocky. Okay, so this is going to be his stealth rocker. Probably why it's called Rocky. What do we see? Zen Headbutt, Seed Bomb, U-Turn, and Recover. So, interesting. That's actually not a bad set to take on a good number of my things. He's got the Seed Bomb, which would hit pretty hard against my Hippowdon. He's got the, So, the fact that I see Recover screams to me that he's not Scarfed. So, me being Scarfed means I will outspeed him. The U-Turn means I'll hit him 4 times super effective, so he might have to switch out here, giving me momentum. If he opts to stay in, I can think about the best switch thereafter. I'm clicking U-Turn. He's gonna withdraw straight away. A good move on his part. He could not risk getting 4 times super effective hit by that. So, I'm going to make note of that set. U-turn, Zen, Head, Seed, Bomb, and Recover. Now, we see Hot Dog. Potentially offensive. We've seen Scarfed variants in the past. Nautumnauto seems like he could be a good switch for me. Let's play around with his team on my so I have a good vision of this. He did not bring this. He did bring that. He didn't bring that. Okay, there we go. Hippowdon will wall this. This gives me a turn to get rocks up. He'll likely go for a burn. I could also go into decisions, the Entei. Do I think that Arcanine has a move for me? He does learn Rock Climb and Rock Smash. But I don't think he has any Rock type attacks. He's got Hidden Power, Rock. Yeah, so I'm going to go into decisions. He can't burn me. If he's offensive, he could hit me very hard. But without getting the, we see leftovers, so not necessarily a fully offensive variant. Last time he brought this against me, he did have Toxic on it. I do have a means of getting rid of Toxic on this team. Stone Edge, without him having an Intimidate on me, will hit him very hard. His only other potential switch into a Sacred Fire is the Jellicent. I think Toxic is the better play here, though. I'm going to click Toxic because I really don't see the only thing immune to Toxic switching in on me. He could switch in the Celebi, but again, I really don't think he sees the Toxic. I'm going to click Toxic here. He's going to withdraw. Who's he going to? Jellicent is my prediction. Requiem for a Dream, the Jellicent. Excellent. So, we get off a Toxic on this beast. That's going to go a long way. That's going to seriously impede his staying power. Seriously impede it. Now we could predict a Scald here. We could predict a Burn. A Taunt. We could switch into, I'm going to make note that we saw Leftovers on the Arcanine. With the Jellicent in here, I think Ditto's a good switch. It'll give me lots of information. If he opts to go, he might not go for the Willow because if I stayed in with Decisions. The fact that he's seen the Toxic might make him think that I'm not choiced. I'd like to see what he's got. I'm going to go into Remix here. I really don't want to get burned if he does predict the switch and go for the Willow. That would be unfortunate, but I do have opportunities to get in later and remove that. But I will force me to switch if I see that he has Hex in addition. He's going to actually double out back into whom? Hot Dog. So this actually is okay for me. Except that he might have Wild Charge. He could very well have Wild Charge. Let's have a look at what he's got on this set. This is his Jellicent set, and he's running Scald, Hex, Toxic, and Recover. Scald, Hex, Toxic, Recover. I could go for the Scald here. It would hit Hot Dog very hard. I'd like to see how much a physically defensive Jellicent, who has the unfortunate base HP of a Ditto, will take from an Arcanine. I'm going to give him 252 attack just to be safe, and I'm going to give him Wild Charge because I think there's a good chance he's got it. It should really only two-hit KO me. I think I'll click Scald here. Scald will hit him very hard. Hex will hit him not so hard. I could also click Toxic. But you know what? I'm going to click Scald here. He could switch back into the Jellicent, and he might. And if he does, that's fine. He's going to switch into Uzair. As I go for the Scald, I'd love to get a burn on this guy. We get a disconnect. And we see Leftovers on the Uzair. This should be relatively easy to recreate. Let's try and do it now. Okay, we have recreated this turn for turn. I click Scald here, and we're going to do that much damage to Uzair and not get the burn. So this is good. We can now continue on from where we are. So here's my thought process. I've had a lot of time to think about this. Seeing this, I anticipate it is a sub or a nasty plot set. We need to get Remix out of here, because if it is, lots of things can break his sub, so I don't think he's a subset. I think he clicks Nasty Plot here, knowing that that allows him, with the Leftovers set, to two-hit KO trip with Psychic. So that would mean he's got Nasty Plot, probably Thunderbolt, and Psychic, and then maybe, I'm not sure what the last move would be. I can also go into my Aromatisse here, but I don't think it's the right play. I could click Scald, anticipate him to go for. The problem is, I think it's so dangerous to stay in. but I don't really need Remix. But the thing is, if I let him get to plus two on me here, he'll just kill me the next turn, and then I'm too yeah, I gotta switch into Trip here. He could be Sub and Nasty Plot. That wouldn't be great for me. But I gotta go with my gut until I know what he's got. This is my safest play and my best answer to him. We see Knockoff. Okay, so we see the Knockoff. So he's not at plus two. Okay, this is good. This is okay, actually. With no item, a Psychic will hit me for about 43 if this set is... I mean, he could be modest. Let's count that he's modest. Phone, you gotta stop. 40 to 47%. I'm gonna click Spore. Because he is not anticipating this. Oh my... Yes, baby. Come on, stay in. Go for the Psychic. No, he's gonna switch. Please don't switch into Celebi. Hot dog. He switches into hot dog. And I get a Spore off. Man, I was really hoping that would land on Uzair. I was really hoping that. Okay. It is unlikely that he stays in here. Who would he switch into to try and take advantage of this? Sludge Bomb's not going to hit a lot of things for very hard. Hot Dog is one of the only answers he has for Cuddles. If I switch now to Cuddles and he switches to Uzair, I'm not in a great spot. If he switches, he will likely switch first, and whatever comes in would be the equivalent of Remix coming in on it to revenge kill it. So, if that's the case, one option is Decisions. Decisions, E-Speed will do a lot of damage to several things. The Jellicent, I wouldn't really like this, but I can, you know, I can double switch around the Jellicent. I'm going to switch into Decisions here. Because without the Intimidate going off, he's actually going to stay in with Hot Dog. Maybe he has Sleep Talk? Oh no. Yeah, I mean maybe, you know, he's just going to try and burn Sleep Turns. Here I click... I think I click Stone Edge. Try and put in some work on the Jellicent with Stone Edge. I'm gonna click Stone Edge. He's gonna stay in. This is a two-hit KO on this man. This is a one-hit KO on this man! Entei! Entei the Beast! That wasn't even a crit, guys! That wasn't even a crit. Oh my word! Entei! Entei with the kill! Entei kills Arcanine with Stone Edge. Arcanine is gone. We are at an early 6-0 lead, and Entei was the best answer he had for Cuddles. Cuddles now does a lot of work to his team. Now he could switch into Uzi here, Uzair. I wouldn't recommend that for him because I could just pop off a Stone Edge right away. He could switch into the Excadrill. If he does, I'm going to anticipate that he's Scarfed. He's probably calculating right now to see whether or not I'm Scarfed. Without the Sandstorm up, we know he can't be Sand Force. Therefore, we know that Hippowdon can take him on. Because even if he's... I mean, he could be Mold Breaker. I don't know why he would be, though. For my one levitating Pokemon, which is Latias, who I didn't even bring last time. This is huge for me. This is absolutely huge. And now I'm able to Spore with this Amoongus on something else. He could switch into Celebi. Whatever he's doing, he's calking. Okay. Good chance he wants to set up rocks here because we did not see them on the Celebi. I could switch into Remix anticipating that, but I think it's more likely that he goes for... I really think he goes for rocks here. I really do. I really do think he goes for rocks here. So here's what I'm going to... Shoot, no, that wouldn't work out. What I wanted to do was switch to Nado, just in case he goes for an attack to try and eat it up. I think that would... And then double switch immediately into Ditto. And what that would do is tell me if he's Scarf, because if he goes for Scarf rocks... I really think he goes for rocks here, but there's no point in me staying in going for a Stone Edge, which is quad resisted. The thing is that if I switch into Remix on his rocks and he's Scarfed, I can switch moves and go for something to try and take him on. But I die if he goes for Earthquake. I die straight up if he goes for Earthquake. And I'm not willing to do that yet. I gotta play safe. Nado is the play. I think he goes for rocks here. But I can't risk losing a lot of my answers here. I'm still not mega evolved with the Pinsir. He's gonna double out into the Oozair. Into blue. Okay. So he forced me out. He forced me out and went into blue. This could be a subset, but I think he plays it safe and I think he goes for Ice Beam. And that is what Aromalisa was designed to do, to switch into this Pokemon. So let's do this quickly, let's not overthink it. Aromalisa comes in. He could be subset. He predicted that switch to Nado. That was a good play. He predicted that well. Goes for the Ice Beam. I should be able to eat that up. Yeah. Yep. That doesn't do too much to me at all. Now... Moonblast would obviously do a heck of a lot of damage to this guy, but it won't do a heck of a lot of damage to the... Excadrill, who is a likely switch. So I could double. And part of the reason I kind of want to do that. But who would I do it to? So here's my thought process. If he's got Iron Head for the Aromalisa, he'll go for it now. If he's choiced, he won't. He'll probably switch. If he predicts the Moon Blast, he goes into Excadrill. But if I switch into Decisions on the predicted Iron Head or switch into Excadrill, he could go for Earthquake the next turn if he's Scarfed. So that's too dangerous for me. Obviously, I can't switch into Nado. I don't see him going for Ice Beam again. He could have the Iron Head. I might need to scout for it. I need to scout for the Iron Head here. I've got to play this safe. I cannot be foolish here. There's a very good chance he switches, but I have to play this safe. He is gonna withdraw. I think he's choiced. The reason I clicked Protect there. Requiem. I absolutely had to do that. And the reason was if he had Iron Head and he was not choiced, I would have been in a lot of trouble there. My switch into Entei, as it turns out, Requiem wouldn't have been a good idea. We know he's got Scald, Hex, Toxic, and Recover. He likely goes for Toxic here. I'm free to click Moonblast and then click Aromatherapy next turn. But if he's going for Toxic, I might as well just switch into Trip. Might as well just switch into Trip if he's clicking Toxic. Yeah, let's switch into Trip. Last time we matched up, he had Willow on this thing, which actually made him a little bit more effective against Trip. Trip no longer has his assault vest due to the knockoff. The exact situation I envisioned. He's gonna double into Rocky, and we know he has the Zen headbutt. He is switching so much. He's switching so much. My phone is ringing. The Zen headbutt will hurt. The U-turn will also hurt. The seed bomb will hurt. Yeah, we gotta predict something here. No matter what he clicks, something he does is gonna hit something else pretty hard. I think the best switch for me is Entei. Against a Celebi. We can assume that it's offensive. That wouldn't be the end of the world. Maybe it would be Jolly. Shoot. Yeah, he's not gonna do too much to Entei. I feel like Entei's a safe switch for me. I'm gonna switch into Entei here. On an anticipated, probably U-turn, but potentially Zen Headbutt. The Zen Headbutt shouldn't do more than 40%, assuming he's jolly fully offensive. Let's see. Zen Headbutt, as predicted. And it does about 40. So he's probably, he's Life Orb. Interesting. 44 to 51. Yeah, okay, so probably Jolly Life Orb. Jolly Life Orb, he hit me for 91. If he's Jolly, he will outspeed, and I anticipate that means he'll go for another one. If he does go for another one, I can switch into Remix and take it just fine. But I think it's more likely that out of fear that he switches into something to take the Sacred Fire. So I could go Remix, and I think I will. No, he would U-turn then. He wouldn't. He does have a chance to kill me here. E-speed would do not as much as I'd like. I'm gonna go into Ditto. I'm gonna go into Ditto here. He's gonna withdraw Rocky. We see that he's faster. We know he's jolly. And we see he goes into Requiem, who is poisoned. As I go into decisions, or go out of decisions, into Remix. So now that I am also a Jellicent, I could click Hex on this man. I could click Hex on him. Have a little Jellicent v. Jellicent standoff. Obviously, my Hex will hit for a lot more. I'm gonna click Hex here. Because it's stab and it's nice, he is gonna stay in. This should do quite a lot. That is a two-hit KO if I've ever seen one. He's gonna opt for the Toxic. Whew! One more will kill this man. One more will kill him. I anticipate he's gonna switch. Switch or go for recover. If he wants to try and take the hex and continue a setup, then maybe he would go into Uzair. He could go for a hex himself. I'd like to go into Aroma Lisa here. Would I? Aroma Lisa, and then I can click Moonblast. He might switch into the Excadrill. I haven't done much with Cuddles. If I want to play offensive, I gotta get Cuddles in here before he gets up rocks. Hex would kill this, but he's so low and he's toxic. He could click Recover, but I could definitely generate some real momentum here. He goes into Uzair. I want to get up rocks so badly, but I do need this for Excadrill. No, I don't even think I need it for Excadrill. Well, maybe I do. Let's go into Trip here. And, because Trip is not a great switch in anymore. I think he's switching out, and I think he's going into Uzair. He is switching out. Are you going into Uzair? Blue. Man, my original guess was to go into Aromatisse. I should have listened to myself. I can't take an Ice Beam from this guy. I just can't. I gotta go into Aromatisse. Super unfortunate. If he has the Iron Head, we'll see it. I hate playing this obvious. I thought it was the Uzair that was coming in, which is why I made the switch that I made. He is gonna go for Ice Beam. I'm gonna click Wish. Yeah, I'm gonna click Wish here. We'll kind of see what happens, what he opts to go into next. He might stay in and try and go for a kill. If he does have the ability to switch up moves, we'll see it. We saw that he didn't take any life or recoil from either of the two attacks. So I'm assuming, I mean, he could be Expert Belt, but my assumption is that he's Choice Scarfed. He is going to stay in and go for Ice Beam again. As I go for a Wish. I have to go for Protect here, unfortunately, because I don't want to let Aroma Lisa go down. Actually, I could just switch. I could switch into Decisions, probably take the... I mean, how much damage does this do? I want to verify that this is Scarfed damage. Kyurem, Choice Scarf. He's probably not timid if he's Scarf. He's probably modest. Aromatisse. Ice Beam hitting for about 70. Yeah, that seems right. I think he's modest Scarf, which means that Entei... Can you take a modest Scarf? Ice Beam. 63. Entei could take it and then get healed up a lot by the Wish and proceed to click Sacred Fire now that there's no longer things that can take it. I'm trying to play this a little more offensive. He's going to switch now. So actually, Entei is going to be brought to full. As he goes into Rocky. Sorry, buddy, but now you are behind the eight ball. You are really behind the eight ball. A couple of different things I can do here. He might sack the Jellicent. Stone Edge, clicking Stone Edge would bait in then the Excadrill. I think I click Sacred Fire. I click Sacred Fire. He's going to withdraw probably into the Jellicent, probably sacking the Jellicent. Yep. Jellicent will go down to this. Yep, there goes the Jellicent. Jellicent is now gone. Okay, 6-4, but the Aromatisse is low and has very few switches into the secure room at this point. I may have to opt to start doing some weird sacking games playing with speed ties, because a scarfed cure room, Aromatisse has done a great job. Really great job. Trip is running out of uses here. It's weird, the recover is a weird move on Celebi, because my offensive mon just absolutely decimated it. It gets one shot by Entei, it gets one shot by Pinsir. He's gonna come in here, he could be trying to scare me out with a dragon type move. If he's scarfed Draco, I don't even think kills if I'm at full health. Not even a chance to kill. Sacred Fire probably won't kill either. If he predicts, if he goes for a dragon type move and he's locked into it, Aromatisse can come in and heal itself up. But I think he clicks Ice Beam. I think he over predicts here and clicks Ice Beam. I'm gonna click Sacred Fire because I don't think he can kill me one way or the other. Shoot, he has Earth Power. I live it. That is very surprising. Very, very surprising indeed. Let's get a burn. No burn. He's locked into Earth Power. Trip can probably take that just fine, even without an Assault Vest, I'm assuming. Yeah, the Earth Power will do about 25% to Trip. Maybe even less to Aromalisa, but I don't think I can get two of them off. Let's go into Trip here. Decision's still really useful with a very powerful extreme speed. And with no wish passers on his team, that Kyurem is at the amount of HP it is at, and it will stay there. This shouldn't do more than probably 25%. Less than that. I'm not gonna click Spore because Celebi is real. I'm gonna click Sludge Bomb. Yeah, I'm gonna click Sludge Bomb, trying to get as much damage as possible on that Celebi. Ah, I should have switched into Ditto. Probably. He's gonna withdraw blue. Show me Celebi. Don't show me Excadrill. Rocky, there's the Celebi. This should do a good amount of damage. Might even get a poison on him. That's a two-hit KO. Do I survive a Zen Headbutt from this thing? What we established before is that he's probably timid. And a Zen Headbutt, good chance it kills me, but not a guarantee. I'm gonna click Sludge Bomb again. He's gonna go for the Zen Headbutt. Come on, Trip, live this, baby, live it. Oh no! Shoot, I really thought he could live it. Oh, I didn't factor Life Orb. Oh well. That is an unfortunate misclick on my part. But what that does, that allows me a switch into Pinsir, who can subsequently Mega Evolve, free of rocks, click the quick attack, and I'm not sure there's anything that can really stand up to this at this point. He probably has to let Rocky go down. Actually, I don't think Celebi can do anything to me. I think I can go for Swords Dance. Zen Headbutt, Seed Bomb. Zen Headbutt shouldn't do more than, I mean, I calc that wrong last time. Let's not make that same mistake. Life Orb. Can Kyurem take two? If he can take two, because I'm going to have to quick attack against him. He can take two quick attacks, even at plus two. Well, I'd like to Mega Evolve anyway. I'm not even going to quick attack. I'm going to return. I think he sacks this. No, he doesn't. That's a mistake. He's going to take a lot of damage from this return. This might kill Uzair. A return followed by a quick attack, I think, kills Uzair here. Oh, that does so much damage. Didn't quite kill him. Here's my play. On the anticipated T-Wave, I switch in Remix. If it's not a T-Wave, he played me well. And Remix will be able to choice Scarf up on this man. But I am anticipating a Thunder Wave here. He does go for Thunder Wave. It will fail. I am now in as this Uzair and can proceed to see what I see. I will outspeed him because I'm scarfed and he's not. Wow, he's physical set. Knock off Wild Charge superpower with Thunder Wave. That is impressive, my friend. I really like that. He doesn't have a Mega. I can click Knock Off freely and start dropping items on things. I'm probably going to stay in with Remix until he dies, just knocking things off. He's got to pick something to get knocked off here. If he loses the Scarf on Kyurem, it's essentially useless because everything outspeeds it. It'll kill the Celebi, it'll kill the Uzair, and we'll see the item on the Excadrill, which I predict is a choice Scarf. But he's not in a great position right here. He's not in a great position. Remix is really coming through this match, and I'm really enjoying this match too. Tup is making some amazing switches, really next level plays. He's going to opt to sack the Uzair and see what I lock myself into. This Pokemon is faster than everything else on his team. Let's click off. He now no longer has a Thunderous Eye. This makes Trip a lot less useful, so it's a good thing that he died. It's not a good thing he died, it's just I didn't need him anymore. I don't really need the Aromatisse anymore at this point. I think my offense cleans up. Obviously, things can change, things can happen. I think he needs to go into Excadrill here. This will be my last opportunity for Remix to be Thunderous now that Thunderous has gone down. I anticipate he goes into Excadrill here. Everything else is I think everything else dies except for Excadrill to this knockoff. And even Excadrill probably doesn't want to take it. What a cool set. I feel really bad that it had to end this way. He does opt to go into blue. This seems strange. Maybe on the off chance that I'm not scarfed? But I'm gonna click knock off. Maybe he can live it. Wow. Impressive amount of bulk. This will take me out for sure. That is really impressive bulk. I'm truly, truly impressed by that. Unfortunately for him, having lost his choice scarf, he no longer outspeeds Cuddles. Cuddles can come in, finish him off with a quick attack. I'm gonna do it just, I think he's gonna sack it. He could switch into the, yeah, I think he's gonna sack it. I didn't want to risk any shenanigans whatsoever. I just didn't want to risk anything there. It's not worth it to me. The Kyurem goes down. I'm really, really, really impressed that Kyurem lived that knockoff. Just so impressed. So, I mean, I guess he just wanted... I don't know what the wild charge was for. Because I wouldn't ever switch in a Vaporeon on that. I know it's stab, but what would he hit with it? My physically defensive Mon resist it. I guess maybe just for the Mega Pinsir. Reuben comes in. Now, Reuben could also be scarfed. Ditto is dead. He could be Swords Dance. Could be Swords Dance Life Orb. Could be Swords Dance Life Orb. Rock Slide obviously will kill me. Quick Attack is 41 to 48%. Decisions is low. I'd rather not switch directly into Nado, but I think it's my best bet here. If he's going for an attack, I could sack Aromalisa, have it die, and the Nado comes in. But if he goes for Swords Dance trying to take game, then that means I outspeed it with decisions and can kill it anyway. So if he does go for Swords Dance, I think I'd rather sack Aromalisa here. If he is Swords Dance, that means I outspeed him with both of my threats. I think he's scarfed. So I'm gonna sack Aromalisa here. Stealth Rock. Really? Now? I mean, okay. I'm gonna click Wish here, I think. Just on the off chance that he is scarfed and has to make a weird switch. If he switches right now, then we know he's we know he's scarfed. Man, that was a really ballsy play. If he switches moves, we know I outspeed him. And I can click Close Combat to kill him next turn with Entei. Celebi is low. This is his moment. He can switch. So that means I outspeed him with Mega Pinsir. Which means Mega Pinsir can come in. Yeah, there's the Life Orb. Mega Pinsir will outspeed this Pokemon and can finish it off with a Close Combat. Because we know we outspeed. Click Close Combat here. He could switch into Celebi, but it's too little too late at this point. He should go down to this. And he does. And then I can Quick Attack. I haven't been doing a good job at keeping up with this. I have lost my Aromatisse now. And I have lost my... Where are you? My Ditto. And here we just go for the very safe... Is it very safe? The very safe Quick Attack to finish this monster off. Tup played really well this game. Really, really well. The reason I'm going for Quick Attack here, I know it's I outspeed and could kill with Return. I don't know what kind of... I'm not playing shenanigans here. I'm not playing shenanigans. Quick Attack over some weird... Maybe I misgenned and I don't have max speed or something. Quick Attack should kill. It's super effective and it's from this beast of a Mon. It does kill, and that means the Giantes net a nice 3-0 victory over old man Tup. Tup, I love you, buddy. Everybody, please go check out Tup. He is doing so well this season, and I really, really like that match. That was a fun match. I want to apologize for the last 2 weeks, guys. The weird stall fest. I tried to play this one a lot more offensive, but as you can see, it still became really like moving and motioning for plays. This was a really fun game, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give me that thumbs up. Like, favorite, sub, anything like that. I will leave a link to Old Man Tup's channel in the description down below, as always. My name is Gym Leader Geo. You guys are the challengers. Thanks for stopping by, and I'll see you guys next time.